retired at the level I once did? I don't know. It's a hard question. I mean, after that accident I got in, my arm is pretty well done for. I can't really lift much anymore. I mean, I can still ride pretty good. I don't think I'm going to be ever where I used to be. You know, if I do end up getting back racing, I'll probably be in the lower end of the sport class, not really competing much, but yeah, I don't know. We'll see what happens, I guess. So, mind you, the year I got hurt on a dirt bike, I just started motocross, and that was going to be a training thing for me. First year went pretty well. Second year, rode pretty great. I really got up to speed, was keeping up with some of the A-rider class guys. I went up to a track up in Leona for a while. I was messing around with some of my buddies on the track. We were all riding pretty hard. There was a jump that nobody was really hitting, and then all my buddies hit it, so I was like, all right, well, I got to try to hit it. And I came off the jump sideways, and it flew me off the bike into the face of the next jump. Next thing, I woke up, a bunch of people around me, and my arm pretty much twisted behind my body. Not to be explicit, but that's how it is. After that bike accident, I got all healed up. Physical therapy session, last one went well. I said I was clear to ride again. Snowmobile racing season was coming soon, and I had a factory ride with Yamaha. I was running semi-pro for them. And then throughout the year, you know, we started off amazing. We had top 5 in points for semi-pro, doing pretty well. And I used to race Yamaha, so those sleds were heavy. They're 4-strokes. I went up there, and the first day went well. It was kind of a testing day for us, pretty much, just getting used to the terrain with the big, heavy sleds. And then the second day, we got it pretty much dialed in, and the first race of the day, two guys took off in front of me, then me and another guy took off, and 5 miles down the ditch line, I'd say, you know, we're going 75-80, just booking it. A guy moves over because he heard me coming and lets me pass him. And I go past the next guy, and then we catch up to a different guy, and the guy in front of me passes him, and I go to pass him, and he hit a drift, and him and his sled went probably 10 feet in the air and landed right on top of me, shredded my whole side. Shredded my arm, I shattered my elbow, broke my forearm, ended up in the hospital overnight. Ended up in the ditch, sleds were just tumbling. I sat there for probably 20 minutes before someone came. They came there and loaded me up in the ambulance. I was fine, I felt fine. They cut my clothes off and they found out that I was cut pretty much wide open in my stomach area. Threw me in the ambulance, brought me to the hospital, threw me on an airplane, flew me to Fargo, North Dakota, and I went under surgery there. Cut me open so deep that I was an inch away from being completely dead. So, I mean, I'm very, very lucky and thankful to be alive. And the next day I went home, but man, it was a tough accident. That's the one that ended my career. So after that one, I just said it wasn't worth it for me. Yeah, so I took all that passion I had for the sleds and the bike, and I needed to find a new hobby. Some of my friends that I grew up with, they were big into cars, and I would never even thought about that. I was always a truck guy and, you know, whatever. You know, I've always wanted a Subaru, so I bought my first WRX my sophomore year in high school. I had that for, you know, probably a year. I sold that, and, you know, I absolutely love the car scene. I started going to, like, events and meets and everything like that, and I just said, well, this is going to be my new hobby. I mean, it's something to do. I love the cars. I mean, I love going fast, and adrenaline I got into the sleds and put that in working on cars and making them fun and fast, and that's what I do for fun now. I mean, that's all it is for me, is the car stuff. And I mean, I absolutely love working on stuff, love driving the cars, and love having a blast. Like I was saying, the car scene is obviously a lot different than what I was used to, and I mean, as I went to these events, I noticed the people are obviously different. They're all enthusiasts, which was nice, because I mean, that's what I grew up with here. That's what I learned on was when I got into cars, is I noticed that everybody was an enthusiast. And I mean, when I was in sleds, everyone loved sleds and they loved racing. And, you know, and it was nice to have a hobby that I could jump into, and everybody in that hobby was the same way they were when I was into sleds and stuff. And, I mean, I was kind of impressed that everyone, there was that many people into cars. I didn't really know for being in northern Wisconsin, I didn't know that it was the big hobby, but you just have to find the right crowd, you know. And I mean, like I said, I absolutely love it, and it's probably never ever going to end for me. I absolutely love cars, so... As bad as I want to, I can't, but if I could, I'd get back on a sled today and start racing again, but I can't, so I had to sell it, and I took that money and just got into cars with it. I had no knowledge on cars at all, especially, you know, tuner cars and nothing like that. I bought a 2002 WRX, and I just learned as I went. I mean, I hung out with the people, and they taught me some things, and pretty much the basics of what every, you know, the turbo cars were. I bought an Evo, Mitsubishi Evolution. I think that was my most favorite car I've had, the first Evo I had. I bought it, drove it off the showroom floor, modded it myself in my garage, taught myself how to do everything, along with help from YouTube and all that stuff. I pretty much built that car in my garage and, you know, made it fast, made it worthwhile. And I learned pretty much from what I learned on that is what I still use today. I mean, that was a learning experience for me. Then after that Evo, I mean, I got in trouble speeding with it because I was a young kid at the time. I had to sell it. After that, I, you know, wanted to get another Subaru, but I couldn't really afford at the time another turbo car because I was living in Minneapolis at the time. And so I bought a Forester. You know, I bought it for cheap and messed around with that. I absolutely loved it. It was just, it always broke people's necks. And they were always asking me what kind of car was it. And after I got my license back and smartened up a little bit, I ended up buying another WRX, a 2003 WRX, so 1 year newer. Had that for a while. Did a little bit more learning on that car. I had to replace the turbo and do some engine mods to it. I learned how to do all that stuff on that car. Definitely a fun project car. I miss it, even though it was a pain in my butt. So I sold that car. Bought another Forester. this time, this one was an 05. It was a newer Forester. This Evo, I picked it up pretty cheap. It's a rebuild title, so I get a lot of crap for it, but I still love it. Picked it up for cheap. I came across another Evo. I always wanted another Evo. I had some other, you know, supporting mods to it. I did pretty much cosmetic stuff, carbon fiber stuff. Then I got in an accident with it and got it fixed. Didn't have any issues with it. And then I had it for a couple months and I hit a deer, so I had to replace everything and go full red. Until I can afford to paint it, that's the color it's gonna stay. But I mean, it doesn't really matter about the color of the car or the title status, I guess, in my opinion. It just matters if you love your car or not, and if you're still an enthusiast, you'll respect everything. So